So good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the final part of our video, of our Vegas trip. So we're heading downtown today. We've got our flight leaves at 8 o'clock this evening, so we've got about 12 hours to kill. I say, what a better place to kill 12 hours in Vegas. So we are heading to Rira at Mandalay Bay for some breakfast, and then we're going to check out and head downtown. Oh, I need to speak to MLife as well to hopefully try and get some of these resort fees waived. We've put about $800 on the room bill through eating and drinking, and I dread to think how much through the slots. So let's see if MGM can look after us. Okay, just a very, very quick update. I thought that we'd be able to get some sort of cash back or resort fee waived from Mandalay Bay. Something I touched on this in the last video, but we spent over almost $900 on food and drink, and the resort fees, etc., since we've been here. I don't know how much we put through the slots, but I would imagine altogether it's probably in the thousands. So I just went to the MGM Rewards desk, said, "Hi, is there anything you can do? You know, you've only been here 4 days, but I've spent quite a bit on food and beverage. Put a fair amount through the slot, you know, obviously not a high roller by any stretch of the imagination, but done a fair bit." The answer was, "We can give you $4 back." So I said, "Don't even bother, what is the point? $4. We stayed at Excalibur in 2019. Okay, we was here for a bit longer, but I'm pretty sure we weren't gambling loads and loads at MGM properties, and we weren't spending what we've spent in this short time we've been here. So I thought they might even waive, you know, 1 or 2 days, but they weren't happy to waive anything. I mean, the other side of the coin is we did get the room for free. We just had to pay resort fee and credit. So, you know, it's not all bad, but just considering what we have spent, I thought we might have got a little something, but never mind. So we're going to check out now and move to downtown. We're going to take all of our cases with us, leave them at the bell desk at Circa, do a bit of exploring downtown, go to 8 East, grab some drinks. I really want to go back to Whiskey Liquor Up. Again, that's another favourite bar of mine. So hopefully we'll do that. And hopefully we can try and win something downtown to keep the pot going. So anyway, cheers for watching, and I'll see you downtown. Just had a couple of hours at Whiskey Liquor Up. Do you know what? When we went to Skyfall, I was like, this is the best bar in the world. I think that's just been demoted. We've just had I said it last time I was here with my dad, just had the best time. The bar rotates round, the drink is so good, the food is great. I think that's it. I think we're done. I think this is my new favourite. It's been completely changed. So we're gonna head over to Circa now. We've drunk a few of these barrels dry that was in here. So on to Circa, I think. Hopefully win a bit of money, and then on to 8 East. So we just had a bit of a touch at the D. went in there after whiskey liquor up. We invested 100 in the hot stuff, which is what we've been playing all holiday. And we put 100 in and took out 250. So we've had a bit of a result now. Starting to make back some of this money we've lost from the strip. And now we're off to 8 East at Circa. We've only got a couple of hours left, so we're going to make the most of it. Anyway, we'll see you now. So as you can see, we're back at the airport. We had quite a good run today, but we are both shattered. Real good day downtown, lots of nice food, a little bit of luck, but do you know what, we're so out of it. We'll recap when we're back in sunny England, so we'll see you there for the final part of the vlog. Good evening, we are back home. So before we leave it, well, left it too long, I thought we would just sum up the trip. So if we start with day four, we didn't really talk too much about that because we were shattered at the airport, weren't we?
I was about to yawn then, I'm trying to like stop it.
Jet lag has killed us this time round.
I don't think we've ever slept so much.
It's the first time really we've done it with Jude. I think that's made it all the more challenging. But yeah, anyway, day four. If I start with the gambling stuff, we actually had a really good day at day four. We turned a profit in the D of about 100, 150 from memory.
Mm-hmm.
We lost a little bit at the airport, but I'll come on to the overall losses of the trip in a minute, but really good. And we ate at 8 East, which obviously we showed you, and we had a couple of drinks at Whiskey Liquor Up. To be honest, it's pointless going too much into that because I think they're both going to feature in our highlights anyway. So if we start with the booking process, and I've had a couple of questions on this to say, how did you get the flights and stuff? So first of all, we've both got Virgin Atlantic credit cards. So what you do with that, anything you put on the credit card, you earn air miles for, and you can then redeem them on flights. So what we did originally was we booked a premium, which was 55,000 points, which sounds like a lot, but I put every penny I spend on the credit card. So every month, pay it off, start again, and it does build up surprisingly quickly. Mm-hmm. And if you spend over 20,000 a year, you get a companion voucher, which meant Charlotte didn't have to spend anything. Any of her points to come along with me, which is nice. And then you just have to pay like the air duty, which for the premium ticket I think was about 500 each from memory. So it was
about $1,000.
Yeah, it's about $1,000 for both of our tickets. Do you want to touch on how we upgraded just as you've got
just
your cup of tea?
Actually,
go on, hold that thought. I'll talk through the hotel just while you have your cup of tea and your Honolulu cookie. So that's how it was booked originally. The standard Delano I got through MGM Rewards, previously M Life. So for anyone who hasn't got that, that is you sign up to MGM, and when you gamble, eat, drink any of their properties, you give them your card and you earn points. for any play or food to spend, and then you get offer sent through. So the offer for this trip was 4 nights at the Delano. The scenic suite that we got was completely free of charge. We just had to pay the resort fee and taxes, which worked out to just under $200 for the 4 nights. So that was really good. But anyway, so that was our original package. So $1,000 on the flights and say $200 for the hotel. And then you had a bit of a brainwave, didn't you?
What about the...
About the upgrade.
Yeah, so for a bit of context, so because of my work, I get to fly to New York once a year. And a couple of years ago, I flew to New York. And because I caught a night flight home, I got to fly business. And I've always said to Laurie, it was the best experience. And I did it with Virgin as well. I was like, it's the best experience I've ever had. And I always told Laurie about the bar on there and how he was outraged that I spent 6 hours sleeping on the plane
and not at the bar
and didn't use the bar. So we always said, like, if we could, it's like a once in a lifetime thing, like, to go. And I had this really weird, I don't know, like this inkling, didn't
like a premonition,
like the day before. And I was like, well, we'll get upgraded tomorrow. We might have to pay for it, but we'll get upgraded. And Laurie was like, you're talking nonsense. We then walked into town and a bird did its business on me, which in the UK,
meant to be good luck.
We see as good luck. So I was like, okay, well, that's a good sign. Then got to the airport and I said, well, let's just try it. You never know. We had a figure in mind of what would be kind of our biting point and our limit. And then, yeah, to be fair, you were the one that spotted the ticket desk because I would have just walked straight through.
When I went with my dad last year, I remember seeing the ticket office in the far corner of Terminal 3 at Heathrow. And I don't know why, but it just stuck in my mind and that was there. So when we got there, I was like, actually, let's go there first. Let's just see.
Have we said how much it was?
I think I mentioned how much it was, yeah.
So yeah, when she said, oh, that'd be £719 each. Now, Laurie doesn't, and I don't think he'll mind me saying this, but he doesn't really do things on a whim or spontaneous. I can kind of just go, yeah, go for it. Laurie's very planned, itinerary based. Everything is like planned to perfection. So I looked at him and I thought, there is no way he's going to do this. And to my surprise, he was like, yeah, let's go for it. Then we had a bit of a palaver because of my credit card and passport being in two different names. I've got one in my maiden name and one in my married name. So then for about 10 minutes, I was standing there searching through everything on my phone for our wedding certificate, which luckily...
But we got there.
I had. But yeah.
So it was, say, just over 700. And in my mind, I was like, anything 500 or less, I'm okay with. 600... probably just about. 700 is my limit. So when it's 719, I was like, oh, am I really going to say no for an extra £19? And I'm so glad we went for it. It was just the most incredible experience. The clubhouse at Heathrow is like no lounge that you've ever been in before. Like, we've done Number One, we've done Aspire, we've done My Lounge, all of those that you pay sort of like 50 quid for or whatever.
Sorry, if I keep looking down as well, it's because we've put Jude to bed and I've got his screen down there and he's currently looks like he's doing roly-polies in the bed. So just
looks like he's doing the conga in his cot. But yeah, just the clubhouse is incredible. Absolutely incredible.
The food was amazing as well.
The food was great. And they have like a little QR code on your table. You scan it, it gives you the menu. You just pick what you want. Food, drink, you name it. You just select it, click done. And literally within 30 seconds, 2 minutes, over they come, tray, champagne, beers.
It's like using the Weatherspoons app, but better.
Yeah, but you don't have to pay for it. I mean, obviously you've paid 700 quid to get through the front door, but...
We did learn a trick, though, with the champagne. So we met a really nice couple on the plane who was sat opposite us. And they told us that apparently when you ask for champagne, they give you the cheapest bottle. Whereas if you go up and you actually ask for which one you want, they'll give it to you. I mean, tips and tricks if you go.
I think we had one glass each, didn't we, of champagne, just to say you do it. You've done it.
It gives me a headache, so I can't.
Working my way through the beer menu anyway, so I wasn't too fussed about that. But yeah, it was, what a way to start your holiday. And I really think that's spoiled us now. It really has.
like the journey on the plane was great. So much room. And Charlotte mentioned about the bar. I think I spent 3 hours, maybe a bit more, at the bar, to the point where Charlotte was like, you need to calm down and be quiet.
Because what it is, the flight was 4:15 UK time. So at this point, it's probably getting on to like 8-9 o'clock, and people are like trying to like lay down, relax, and all I can hear is someone at the bar getting louder, louder, louder.
In my defence, we got to the clubhouse at what, like 12:30, 1 o'clock, whatever. And then you're having drinks in there, and then you get on the plane and you have the takeoff drink and the welcome drink, and then you got at the bar and it's pretty free flowing. But it was great.
There was a few of you up at the bar, and all of a sudden the seatbelt signs were
yeah, and there was no turbulence.
that's a sign.
Anyway, it was absolutely fantastic. Food on the plane was great. I mean, my starter was smoked salmon and caviar. The main was trout in a Thai green sauce. Just amazing. The staff was great. If anything, now I'm like, okay, I would rather not go for a little while longer and do it that way. Mm. Traveling back premium was a lot harder than... Oh, that makes it sound so... It wasn't the best of flights, was it? We had turbulence, which didn't
the
help.
Premium wasn't the problem. The problem was me. Let's be honest. The issue with the flight home was me. So I am not a fantastic flyer. For those of you that might follow me on Instagram, things like that, I actually suffer with anxiety. So I find flying quite nerve-wracking anyway. Being away from Jude quite a long way away, I found quite difficult, and I was just quite anxious to get home. My biggest thing with flying is the taking off. Hate taking off. And just before we were due to take off, the captain was like, yeah, so obviously there's a storm back home, which is kind of like going across the Atlantic, which we're going with. Flight's going to be pretty bumpy. And immediately I went into panic mode, so...
And it was, to be fair. It was quite bumpy. So it meant that I would say for at least 60% of the flight, around that, we had the seatbelt sign on, which restricts you, I think, on that kind of time frame.
And the times when it didn't, I was in the toilet throwing up.
Yeah, Charlotte wasn't in a good way. So I suppose that has dampened the way home. But when you compare the two experiences, it's night and day. Like the room you have in business, the food you get, the drinks you can have.
Yeah, you wasn't keen on the food, was you?
Service was appalling in premium on the way home. Honestly, it was like microwave, poor microwave food.
As I say, make sure you say food, because the service from the crew were actually pretty good.
Service was good, but we were spoiled. We were incredibly spoiled, on the way out there.
From my experience, I don't know if they're ever going to see this, but I want to shout out Zoe and Jacqueline. So Jacqueline basically looked after me most of the flight, where I was quite unwell. So she was bringing me teas and, you know, every time she went past, she checked on me.
Couldn't have fought Virgin.
Stuff absolutely incredible. Really, like, tried to calm me down and things like that. So shout out to them. But, yeah, you weren't amazed by the food.
No, our food wasn't great. But anyway, that was the booking process. That's how we got to where we did. So overall, we paid $1,000 originally for the flight, $200 for the room, and then just over 700 each for the upgrade to business on the way out. So really, you're talking, what, say 2.5 roughly, yeah, which I don't think is bad considering the hotel we was in and the flights we had. So moving on to gambling, I'm watching some of these videos back. I'm conscious I've sounded quite negative and miserable at points.
He spent too much time with me.
Could be that. And on reflection, we had an absolute blast, amazing time. Vast majority of it, we really, really enjoyed, didn't we?
Yeah.
I found I was getting frustrated with probably three things. It was, we had some awful luck at times with the gambling, and I know that's the chance you take. I think more so it was like when we went to Ellis Island and playing blackjack, I've spent hours at the table before and like come away level or slightly down, and you've had a good time, you've met some good people, you've had good interaction with the dealers, you've had some free drinks. I was off that table within about 20 minutes, $100 lighter, one drink, no banter with the people. So I think that's why I was getting frustrated. It just didn't feel right.
I think as well, I think a big part of it is we had that win last time.
I don't expect that ever again.
But I think, like, I know for me, you kind of, like, where you win it once, you're almost like, oh, it could happen at any time again. Because it could. It could happen at any time again. So I do wonder whether that has almost not dampened it at all, but I wonder if it's kind of like...
So I don't think so, personally. Not? Like, the couple of wins we had a Buffalo win at...
About 85, I think.
Yeah. Was that at Sahara? I can't even remember. But we had a half-decent Buffalo win. We had a half-decent All Aboard win at Cosmo. We had a win at the D on the Red Hot Machine.
Yeah.
Little bits and pieces. Fine. I don't expect to win $3,500 every time we're over there. Of course not. But I just want a little bit of a run for my money. And when you're sat at a blackjack table for like... 20 minutes for $100 playing $5 a hand and you're not getting a drink, you're not having any fun, that's what sticks with me.
For me though, it was Moolah when we sat down and we run 50 through and we were literally off of it in about 3 minutes.
It was the same song playing at Park. We literally sat, again, we're low rollers, right? And I know some of these games you have to invest more than $50 to get any kind of run on it, but I think that's one of the things that's really stuck out for me. Two was the drink service, kind of touched on that a second ago. Definitely feels it has quietened down.
The place where it was really good was Cosmo.
Yeah, Cosmo was great. I think Cosmo's always been pretty good for a drink service. But like I was saying to Charlotte, even at Mirage last year, me and my dad was playing the Hot Stuff game that we played quite a bit this year. And we must have got 4 drinks off of a $50 loss. So like literally every, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes, they would come round, drinks, cocktails, whatever. We never had one session where we had more than one drink. And we was putting hundreds through. Like, it wasn't as if we were just putting $20 in. So I definitely think that's changed. Although I'm not sure if it's because it was how busy it was out there. And it was busy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't realise when we booked it, but it was spring break. So there was families everywhere, kids everywhere. And it was, you know, personally, I don't think I would take Jude until he's 21. But if people want to take kids, that's fine. But they just felt it was overrun with families.
Yeah, it was very
busy. But anyway, and I don't know whether that played part of it. But I think those were the three things for me. I was like, oh, it's really busy. You can't get anywhere without, you know, hundreds of people. You're not getting a drink and we're not having a run on the gambling. Mm. But swings and roundabouts, we did have some...
We had a great time.
We did. We had some amazing food, which I'll come on to in a minute. We had some really good times in the bars, like, and you know, there's certain things with Vegas you can only do in Vegas, and it was great, but it was just those three things I think made it not the perfect trip. Mm. But anyway, so on the gambling front, I sort of touched on this. I've got my profit and loss statement through from MGM today. I've actually read these numbers now because I was quite surprised, but we spun through $2,115. We took out 1,639, which gave us an overall loss of 475. We actually span through more in this 4 days at MGM properties than we did in our 12 days in December 2019. So that's kind of why I was a bit shocked we didn't get any of the resort fees waived by Delano or Mandalay Bay or whatever.
I wonder if it's because it was a...
Conch room. Maybe, but
so, it kind of feels like yeah. Here's your conch room.
How much more do you want?
Yeah, you've got a suite for a cool. What was it? A scenic suite
for nothing.
Oh, you also want your room?
Yeah, I guess maybe I'm being a bit too needy. But it's like we've put over $2,000 for your slots. We've spent £700 on food and beverage credit. Could you at least waive a day of these resort fees, which you don't get anything for, by the way. You don't get anything for it. The Wi-Fi anyone can use. We, as you can probably tell by me, I don't use the gym. Anyone can rock up to the pool. So really, like, it's just a hidden tax. But anyway, so the gambling wasn't too bad. I think
he's had a great time.
Yeah, keep moaning about this. I think on the whole, that minus 475, that's probably representative throughout, I think, because we was... Outside of MGM, we had some wins, but we had some losses. So I think we're probably level outside MGM because we've done well in Cosmo, done well in Sahara, lost a bit of the win, lost a bit Ellis Island. So we're probably level outside of MGM properties. So
did all right,
yeah, I think minus 100 a day, I think it's pretty good considering how much we were gambling. Yeah, exactly. That was between us. So overall, I don't think it's too bad, despite me keep moaning about it. So anyway, that was that. So I just thought we'd quickly cover Delano. What did you think of Delano?
I loved it.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was just like, although everywhere was really busy, it felt like the one place that wasn't that busy. There was a conference there, but the amount of times we walked through, like, to get... Yeah. There's like a walkway to get through to Mandalay. That was always like quiet. Mm. We keep saying this. The smell in Delano was so not. There's something about Vegas hotel smells. I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
But every time you walked in, it was just like this lovely smell.
Mandalay and Delano smell great.
Yeah.
And I only realised today, but they've got a shop where you can buy candles with the scent. And I am kicking myself for not bringing a caseload of them home because. Yeah. Well, yeah, as you said, when you come from Luxor into Mandalay, that smell. That
smell, yeah.
But yeah, I thought it was great. Yeah. I thought it was really good.
I mean, like, I know you were a bit disappointed with the view.
Yeah.
But I thought, like, I love looking at Mandalay Bay because I just find Mandalay Bay so, like, impressive to look at. So being, like, directly facing it, I was more than happy
with.
And we had, like, the airport, we had the pool view, and then we could see a bit of Luxor. But as I've tried to remind Laurie's, like, the last two times we went to Excalibur, the first time we had to move rooms because they put us in a room that was facing a wall.
It's true.
Then they moved us to a view of the Luxor, and then the second time we were facing the
monorail.
Monorail.
Yeah.
In a really low room that we were, like, eye line with the monorail. So in terms of, like, rooms we've stayed in...
Oh, yeah, it was by far
the best, and the view was by far the best.
It's probably one of the best hotel rooms I've ever stayed in, full stop. So the reason I was disappointed, I'll keep moaning, I feel awful.
This is like, you're turning into me. It says
I'm getting older. The reason I was disappointed, like when you look on TripAdvisor and Instagram and stuff, you see these incredible views on these corner suites. And the way Delano is set up, there's four corners or scenic suites on each floor. Two of them are directly facing the strip. One of them is half facing the strip and one of them is facing the airport. So I was like, okay, we've got a 3 out of 4 chance of getting a half decent one. I just don't want the airport one. Give me any of the others that are strip facing or partially strip facing.
And I
tipped the front desk. I was like, look, give me the best strip view you've got. Yes, Mr. Davis, you know, we're going to give you the best room possible. It's a great view. You're going to love it. And then we got there and I was like, this isn't what I asked for. But like, what can you do? The size of the room was huge. I mean, we didn't really touch the front room part of it, like the living area.
No.
But that was probably bigger than the Excalibur room we had on its own. Two toilets, you know, the bathroom was huge. I can't complain. No. But yeah, I was just slightly disappointed with the view. But, you know, in time, I managed to get over it.
Really? Sounds like you haven't.
I'm still a little bit bitter. But yeah, no, it was a great hotel. And people say, oh, it hasn't got its own casino. Mandalay, it's literally attached to Mandalay Bay and it's 30 seconds walk, if that, and you're on the Mandalay Bay casino floor. So I really wouldn't worry about that. And it's also, as Charlotte said, it's also quite nice to be away from it. So if you don't want that hustle and bustle, you have got that. And I found Mandalay Bay Casino to be pretty good. It's really spacious. Never had trouble getting on a machine.
No.
I found Bellagio last year probably too busy. And a lot of the machines were the $2.50 a spin, $5 a spin, out of our league. Mandalay Bay, there was enough for us to keep us busy being low rollers. So, yeah, fully recommend Delano. So moving on to restaurants quickly. I'm conscious we've been rattling on for a while already. I was hoping we'd be done by now. My tea's going cold. So restaurants, favourite restaurant?
Oh, easy.
Yeah?
8 East. It was... by far some of the best food I've ever eaten. And if that was in London, it would be dangerous. I think I'd be there once a month.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
So we used to go to La Thai, which is just down the road, off of Fremont. I'm pretty sure that Derek Stevens, the guy who built Circa, poach the head chef from La Tire. I might have got that wrong. I'll look it up. But I'm pretty sure that's what happened. Sorry, Juge just stood up. There he goes. He's back down again.
He's trying to find... I don't know what he's trying to find. Oh, dummy.
He's got it. But anyway, he pokes the head chef. And it's just... It's gone up by like... So... It's just unbelievable. I took my dad last year and I was amazed. But if I'm being honest, I think we ordered even better than what I did last year.
So when Laurie came home, he was like, it's the best meal I've ever had. And I was like, oh, so my meals aren't good enough for you. Great. No comment.
Now you agree, right?
Yeah. I was a bit like, yeah, all right, I'll kind of like see for myself. I think like with all the different meals we had, like I was really excited for In-N-Out Burger. Like, obviously, you can only really get it on the West Coast. And I was like, in my head, I was like, right, double-double, animal style with fries. And I was a bit let down by it.
So busy again.
Really busy. So I was let down by that. We'd done loads of research with like the Wind Buffet. We were watching like Travel Ruby.
Yeah, loads of research.
Derek and Catherine.
Yeah. Tim Lee.
We watched so many and was like, right. In my head, I was like, the Wind is going to be amazing. Again, I was let down. I think part of the problem was it was so loud in there. So I just found it really difficult to kind of concentrate where it was so much going on. Then the food itself was good. There was some of it that was like, I think the problem was I went a bit meat heavy on one plate.
The carver is amazing.
I kind of ruined the rest of the meal.
Yeah, Charlotte just had a slice of everything and they've got about 12 meats.
So that's kind of my fault. But yeah, I wasn't like, I think when you do so much research on somewhere and you build it up so much in your head, it's kind of got to meet that expectation. It didn't meet it for me.
I agree with the busyness. The busyness put me off. It was super loud in there.
Yeah.
When I was there last year in Vegas, I've said that about Circa, where it was really loud. I found the Wind to be on a par with that this year. It was just incredibly loud. Couldn't hear yourself think. And there's even like pumping this music through in the buffet.
Yeah, you're trying to like eat your crab legs and all of a sudden you've got like this music bouncing.
And it was just bizarre. So the busyness didn't help. But I think when you watch YouTubers, they hype up like these food review critics. Oh, this is the best meal I've ever had. This is amazing. So you can't help but get sucked into that.
Yeah.
And then you go and it's like, oh, it's all right. It was all right.
Yeah.
The meat was good. But I don't know if it was worth 160. Well, it was more expensive than 8 East for comparison.
Yeah.
And the two meals for me were like night and day.
Yeah. And then we did... What else did we do?
Front Yard was good.
Oh, Front Yard was amazing.
Front Yard was very good at Ellis Island. I would go back there in a heartbeat to have... I mean, we had like a brunch, didn't we? I'd have that again and I'd go back there for an evening meal.
Do you know where else I forgot was... the food at Skyfall Lounge.
Yeah, like we had some like...
We had some beef short rib tacos and they were some of the best tacos I've ever had.
Yeah. And
we had buffalo
chicken wings.
And then we went Vivette's, so that was our last night. Again,
we touched on Vivette's, it was just a bit too rich.
We ordered a bit.
Yeah, that was our fault.
Wrong. But the actual setting of it was beautiful in there.
Yeah.
Wasn't too loud, you were kind of like space away from each other. So like that, but it was just a shame. Like if we'd have gone to 8 East on like the first or second day, I'd have probably had to go back because it was just, it was so good.
Yeah, I would debate, I sort of contradicted myself because I said to you on the downtown day, I probably would never stay here, but I think I probably could. There's probably enough in Circa to keep you busy.
Oh yeah.
But I think they were our food highlights.
If you get to go to 8 East, I would thoroughly recommend it.
Yeah, absolutely.
We got two plates of the lamb.
The lamb lollipops. So good, we got them twice.
Yeah.
Save a bit of room for dessert if you can.
Yeah, our...
waitress?
Our waitress, we asked for the desserts, and I knew one of my favourite desserts was creme brulee, and they did a Thai tea creme brulee, so I was like, well, that's me. And then it was like a honey... sweet bread, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was like a is it like a French toast type?
Almost, yeah. Thing? But in honey with ice cream and toasted walnuts.
Yeah.
And she was like, it's honestly the best thing on the menu. Move that on, gone.
Sold, go on then.
And it was incredible.
Yeah, it was seriously good. I'm so glad we did it.
Yeah.
We come away feeling like, oh my God, like, shouldn't have ate that much, but you can't help it.
I didn't eat until the next evening.
You didn't even eat on the plane, did you?
No, I couldn't.
So at least it kept her going.
Couldn't stop the food on the plane.
But yeah, so I think top pick for us is 8 East. That will be number one. Every time I go back to Vegas, that will be number one to go back to.
Yeah.
So moving on to the drinks out there, I suppose the places we went, Brewdog on day one. We did Skyfall on the evening of the first day. We did Whiskey Liquor Up on the last day. Mm. Other than that, we had Front Yard kind of counts. And we had a cheap one in Casino Royale. So if we start with the cheap ones, Casino Royale, $3 bottles, Center Strip. You know, if you fancy a quick cheap one while you're exploring Vegas, that's a good shout. Ice cold bottles, $3 a go. Ellis Island, their beers are $4, so they've gone up slightly. I think they used to be $3 a pint, they're now $4, but they're still great homebrew stuff. But the main key bars, I say Brewdog, Whiskey Liquor Up and Skyfall, what was your pick?
So we've already spoke about this, but my top bar in the world is Skyfall. Like, for the view, absolutely love it. But out of pure enjoyment, I much preferred Whiskey Liquor Up.
Yeah, I think I mentioned that on the day. It's just great fun.
Yeah.
It's real good fun.
And we got there at 11:30. And by 12 o'clock, all of the seats at the bar, like the rotating bar, gone.
Yeah. A little bit of pre-planning by yours truly. I was like, come on, get there early. Oh, what are we going for drinks for at 11:30? But that's why. Because those seats are hot property on that rotating bar. Mm. I think it was its seat, about 20?
Yeah.
It can't be a lot more than that. But it's great.
The guy who runs the bar, Mo, is just like, I was watching him in awe. Because he doesn't he doesn't write down anything. He just knows exactly what everyone's got.
And he's bouncing from person to person. And the bar's moving around him. It's amazing. Crazy.
It was brilliant.
Yeah.
Loved it. And yeah, he was he made a joke about, he was telling us like he's travelled to the UK quite a bit. And he started pouring a cocktail in front of me and he was like, you don't get measures like this back home. And no joke, the glass was like that and it was filled up to there with alcohol. And I was like, no, you don't.
This might explain why she was dodgy on the plane home, by the way.
I said to him, I'm stuck between two cocktails. And he was like, I'll make you one, like off the menu.
Yeah.
And I saw him pour close to, what's one of them glasses, a pint?
Yeah.
Close to a pint.
Of maybe 500ml, but yeah, just under a pint.
Close to a pint. Of peach whiskey. That could explain why I was very low on the plane.
And we had buffalo chicken wings on top of that. And then ate East. So,
yeah, probably
recipe
it.
For disaster. Yeah. But I agree on that. I think I mentioned that on the video before this, but that was just, we had such a good time there. And it's dear. I think we found the drinks to be dear. I think Brewdog was probably one of the dearest. I think Brewdog was 13 a pint.
Yeah.
Your cocktails were 20 a go.
Yeah, and they weren't amazing.
But what Brewdog's got, he's got a great view. So where we had a lovely day weather-wise, it was just great sitting out there. You're on the strip. You're watching the world go by, so to speak. And you nice cold beer. It's great. It really is good.
But the thing is, with the drinks, yes, they're expensive. But when you actually convert it back to pounds, it's not actually that much different to the price we pay.
It's a bit dearer in London. Yeah, it's London and a little bit more.
Like a cocktail in London, you're looking at between £15 and £20.
The thing that makes it dear is you've then got to add your tax on and your tip. Mm. I think that's where it is more than in the UK. But yeah, I agree. I think Whiskey Liquor Up again is a mainstay for me now. Anytime we're back in Vegas, that's definitely being done.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's it. The only other things I'll quickly ask you is highlight and low light, but let's finish on the positives. Let's do the, what was your low light first of all? I could go for
the plane journey home.
Apart from the plane journey home, I'll go first on this, which is, mine's really simple. Mine was a blackjack at Ellis Island, because that's been a previous highlight and it just wasn't great this time. The dealers weren't that good, weren't really interacting. The dealer moaned at me for not tipping him, but tipping a cocktail waitress.
She didn't hear.
Yeah, Charlotte heard it, but he dealt me 15 hands worth of rubbish and then wants to tip for it. Well, give me a decent hand, mate, and I might tip you. But it just wasn't good fun. We've been there before and it's been a full table, lots of banter. The table opposite was the table we should have been on, because that was absolutely buzzing. There was shouts and screams, drinks flying around. We were just on a quiet table and it just never really got going. So that would be my biggest disappointment of the trip, I think.
I think I've already touched on it. It's probably either the win or in and out. Mine's more food related.
Yeah.
If you know me, I love my food. So yeah, that was probably more so the win. I'd really built it up. We went to the win on our first trip all those years ago, and I was like, right, it's another chance. Like, the food looked so much better. And I just walked away and I was like, I've not really enjoyed it.
The only thing I'll say, Charlotte got a slice of prime rib, and me, it was the best prime rib I've ever tasted. She got the end cut.
I'm kind of thinking I'm being harsh.
It just melted.
It was just like the overall experience for me.
Yeah, exactly. If that busyness and the whole thing, the whole package didn't. Mm. Yeah, and it's dear, right? It's not a cheap meal. It was 160.
It's probably because I paid for that one. Yeah. So it gives me more than
the one meal she paid for. That's my low life.
Yeah.
Biggest highlight.
I think we've already touched on it again. I think for me, it's the last. It's awful, did it? The last day. But I think if we'd have done that earlier on in the trip,
yeah,
I feel almost sad saying it because it was the last day. But I just thought whiskey liquor up and then 8 East was just so good.
I never thought she would say that, because the first time I took her to Fremont Street, she's like, "What are you doing? Are you trying to get me stabbed?" and now it's her highlight. So you know, just funny how things go full circle.
I've changed.
I think for me, it's that first morning. I love that. I'm like a kid at Christmas. I can't sleep that first day. I think we went to bed about 10:30 once we spoke to Jude.
We were up at 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock. I think there was something to do with the chicken tenders that weren't sitting right. There was a bit of that. But that was it. Then I was awake. I was like, right, okay, can I get up yet? Is it time to go to Denny's yet? Is it time to start this strip walk? Which is madness, I know.
But I woke up at 4:30 and he was like, right, we're ready to go. I was like, oh, I could do another hour in bed.
Come on, let's go.
Oh, well, if you want to go back to bed, I'll just leave you in the room. I was like, oh, all right then.
I just love that first day. The casinos are quiet because it's really early. You can get on what you want. The sun's just coming up. The strip's empty. It's really... Oh, by the way, just one thing we didn't mention was slots of fun.
Oh, yeah.
So we actually had a really, really good hour in there. We had a bag of change from previous trips that are full of quarters that they're now taking in the slot machines in there. So we literally sat there for an hour. We had a couple of wins on it and whatever. Had a drink at the bar. The bar was $2 for a Heineken. The barman was good fun. So, again, a little shout out for slots of fun. It's a place previously I've given a bit of a wide berth. But that was a good time in there. Like, first day, that walk up and down the strip, that was my highlight, I think. But yeah. So I think that's it from us. We've gone on by about 25 minutes more than what I was hoping. So we better go upstairs and get some sleep ourselves now, try and get rid of this jet lag. But that's it from us. Thanks for watching this long. If you've stuck through it, you deserve a medal for listening to us moan for this long.
Listen to you moan.
Yeah, listen to me moan. Our next trip isn't too far away, and it's a completely different one. Obviously, it's not Vegas related at all, but we're taking Jude to Greece for our first family holiday abroad, which we're both excited and nervous about. We don't know, very nervous about the flight with Jude. Don't know how he's going to...
And me.
And you now, yeah. Wish me luck. So we don't know how he's going to be sitting in a seat for 4 hours. I mean, he loves planes and trains and all that kind of stuff.
He struggles quite a lot with noises. So.
And sitting still.
Yeah.
That's the bit I'm worried about, him sitting still for 4 hours. But I'm sure it'll be fine. But we'll do a little video for that. And we've got some other bits and pieces later in the year anyway. So no doubt we'll see you then. But thanks for watching. Any questions, obviously, just send them over. We'll do our best to answer. And yeah, we'll speak to you soon. Take care.